Dear viewers, you're watching Serbian Television. My name is Tamara Vesna. With her in studio is Val Rajic. Welcome.
Thank you.
Reason for your visit here in studio is your book, Serbia Faces and Places. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, it's a book project that I have been thinking about for about 10 years to do. The initial thoughts of what to do started with the bombing in 99, but the idea for the book didn't really emerge until about 2005, 2006. As I had visited Serbia every single summer, after some period of time, I acquired several thousands, maybe 10,000 images, and we thought it'd be a great idea to put a book together. The void I thought the book would fill is most of the books on Serbia did not really cover the people of Serbia. They cover the monasteries, the museums, the buildings, the countryside, but there's no book really about the people of Serbia. So what I wanted to do is highlight who the people are of Serbia, and then we can wrap all of the stuff around the people, the monasteries and all the stuff, you know, the villages and the cities and the museums and all that. But the core element are the people that you meet on the streets, in the villages, in the countryside, wherever, because they really are fascinating. It's very easy to go to the green market in Beograd, by example, and spend 2 hours, 3 hours just chit-chatting with the farmers. It's delightful.
Interesting. You're into bookkeeping and the financing, and suddenly book. How did you find that?
I've always loved books. I mean, my house is full of books. Whenever I go to Belgrade, I come back with 4 or 5 books in my luggage. So the book is a natural thing for me.
Mm-hmm. And tell us a little bit more about a reason why you made a book. Like you said, some of your friends ask you questions about Serbia, et cetera, et cetera. So,
well, initially the reason started to be to let the world know what the Serbia is, because what I experience when I go there is so different than what the typical person sees in the media. Because really, it's just the worst of the worst gets. I mean, if it's in the news, it's something bad. So that was the initial reason, but what kind of coaxed me along were some of the strange questions I received from friends and colleagues at work and whatnot. You know, odd questions such as, is it safe to go there? And, you know, I have to explain to them that, you know, Belgrade is relatively safe. It had 20 murders last year versus Chicago 650. It's very safe. I mean, you can walk in the middle of the night virtually any part of the city with no problems. Then I would get questions such as, I was at a birthday party, a kid's birthday party, and a gentleman who's a successful attorney with a successful law practice, I mean, well-educated guy, asked me, so do you get together and celebrate birthdays like this back in Serbia? And, you know, I answered, yes, we do, but I mean, I was thinking all kinds of things that are primarily, gee, he really has no idea who I am, who we are, what Serbia is. And it became apparent that a book like this needed to be done, and needed to be done in English, so that you could give 10 copies to 10 friends at work or neighbors or whoever, because you can spend a half an hour talking with somebody about what Serbia is, or you can spend an hour with them, or you can spend all day with them. The fact of the matter is, they either won't remember what you tell them, or they won't believe you, because they'll believe the TV reporter before they'll believe you, because they figure, you know, you're biased. So, for all those reasons, I thought the book needed to be done. Plus, there was a void. A book like this didn't exist. So that was the reason.
How did you find all those interesting faces?
Just ran into them in the street, in the villages. Mm-hmm. Interesting story. Some of the faces in here are farmers that I met at the green market, Piac. Mm-hmm. Governor Jelicic, the National Bank governor, I ran into him in the street. Mm-hmm. And I introduced myself and told him I was doing a book. Gee, wouldn't it be nice if he was in it? So he finally agreed. Other people, I just called out of the blue. Dasha of Legenda, I got his phone number and I called him on his cell phone. And he said, sure, he'd love it. Boban Marković, I got the phone number for their manager.
It's kind just of mention who they are, because a lot of our viewers don't know the names. Yeah. It's a legend, okay, they're very famous, like a lead singer was opera singer, but he sings popular music, right?
Yeah, they're just extremely popular, Serbian popular music, love songs, a lot of them are love songs. But the brass band, Boban Marković brass band, it's kind of an interesting story. I got their phone number and I called the manager. And I forget what time it was here, but it was like 8 o'clock in the evening in Europe. And so he answered the phone, and there's a lot of noise in the background. So I identified myself, who I was, and I said, is everything okay? There's a lot of noise. No, the boys are getting ready to go on stage in Gothenburg, Sweden. So that's where I caught them with the cell phone. Lazar Stovsky, I contacted him through email, and unlike a lot of the email respondents who aren't very responsive, I mean, he responded immediately. And I've gotten to know him quite well, and he was just delighted to be in the book.
Mm-hmm. I had the opportunity to interview him for Serbian Television, a very famous actor, and also directing now. Mm-hmm. It's a very, very talented. I don't know how many movies he did, 50 plus, whatever.
And he's just a delightful guy.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking at all those gorgeous pictures of the botanical gardens, right? Mm-hmm. And the streets and the buildings, and you went to the castle, right?
The Royal Palace?
Yes.
Yeah. We contacted the Prince Alexander's office in Belgrade and asked his permission to include the palace and Oplenac, St. George's Church, in the book, and they could not have been more accommodating. We spent 4 or 5 hours at the Royal Palaces in Belgrade. Photographing, and then we spent a half a day at the church and the museum, they were just overwhelmed with what they saw. In fact, Prince Alexander commented that it was absolutely the best book that he's seen about Serbia. And I think part of the reason is because it does include people. The book is about the people, much more so than the palace or the building facades or anything else. It's really about the people. It gives you a sense of how vibrant Belgrade is, and how much energy and excitement is there, and electricity in the air.
But those pictures from the castle are absolutely gorgeous. Really, you did an excellent job.
Thank you.
I was there several times, but you really chose great pictures.
Thank you.
Vlade Divac, NBA player.
Yeah.
He is there too, right?
He is. He's moved back to Belgrade with his wife, and they are doing some incredibly important humanitarian work. We thought it was important to include them in the book. Mm-hmm. And I spent a half an hour talking with him at a fundraising event. And that's actually an interesting story about that. First of all, they are doing very important work in terms of resettling the refugees. What they are doing is buying abandoned farm properties, repairing them, and placing refugees in there who are now able to live fulfilled lives, careers, and all that stuff, which is tremendous work. But the interesting story is the most difficult images to acquire for the book, you would think that would be ones from the government tourist office or, some government entities or, going into the royal compound. No, it was getting pictures from the NBA. Because every picture with Vlade Divac where he's wearing an NBA uniform, he doesn't own the rights to that. The NBA owns it. And it took about 3 months of calling and calling and calling and calling to get the NBA to finally give us permission to use the photos. And I think the only reason they agreed is because we indicated to them that the Vlade Divac section was going to be primarily about his humanitarian work back in Serbia, as well as the humanitarian work he did here while he was playing with the LA Lakers. Mm. And so they finally said yes, but that was by far the most difficult image to acquire.
Yeah, humanitarian organization, Divac, HOD, really do great, great, great things.
They are.
And here's our champion, number one, tennis, Nole, Novak Djokovic.
Novak Djokovic, number one. I actually happened to be in Belgrade when Ana was number one as well. She had just won the tournament in Paris. That was 3 or 4 years ago. I included them in the book. I didn't interview them, but I included them in the book because I thought it was important to talk about the contribution they made in rebuilding Avala Tower that was knocked down by NATO during the bombing. Nole and Anna were one of the first to really get some serious fundraising activities underway to acquire the funds to rebuild the tower. And their offices were kind enough to provide images, and they fully supported what we wanted to do.
I just want to thank you. This book is really treasure, looking at all those gorgeous pictures on one place. So really, thank you so much. Probably some of our viewers considering doing something also, maybe not that spectacular like your book, but maybe something to give back to the community. What is your advice?
go for it. Live your dream. The book turned out better than I had ever imagined it would. It was really a work in progress during the entire time. This isn't the book is as we see it today is not what I had envisioned. It was molded and shaped by recommendations and advice that I received from people along the way. A good part of the book that we have now was impacted by Alex Macheski from Cleveland, the former publisher of the Cleveland Plain Dealer. He wrote the foreword for the book, but he also convinced me to include cities beyond just Kragujevac and Belgrade. I wanted to include Kragujevac because of the Spomen Park and the important museum there, and Belgrade obviously because it's the capital, but Alex convinced me that it's really important to include some of these other places like Novi Sad and Subotica and Niš. So we did that, and I smile because after we had completed all the work, we sent a draft copy before it went to the printer to Alex, because obviously, you know, he's lending his name to it and he was important to the project. So we wanted to give him the courtesy of reviewing the book. And so I called him up and I said, well, Alex, what do you think? So I'm thinking he's going to say it's perfect. Go with it. He said, well, it's almost perfect. I said, almost? Mm-hmm. What did I miss? He said, well, you know, I really like Tamburica. And, you know, Janik Balas is such an important Tamburica celebrity, and his statue is in Novi Sad. You really need to include him. I said, Alex, would that make it perfect? He said, yes. I said, it'll be included.
And you flew back to Subotica just to Novi Sad, right?
No, I actually called somebody there, and, uh-huh. and they took 20 images, and they sent me 20 images, and we picked one image and included it, and we did a little write-up on who that is. But that was okay. That's part of the fun. It really is.
I was delighted talking to you. I hope we're going to have an opportunity to see you again, to see how everything goes, maybe talk about this book again, maybe some new project, you never know. I want to thank you so much for taking your time to talk for the viewers of Serbian Television. Please stay with us. We're going to be right back.